Hardware security keys are the best method today for securing your online accounts from hackers. Today, we'll explore AuthenTrend's biometric security key. Hello, everyone. This is Rick with Cybermedics. Today, we'll set up AuthenTrend's biometric ATKey.Pro using the Windows operating system. Then, we'll show you the features by adding and removing the key from a Gmail account for authentication. At the end, we'll share some important security tips to take full advantage of the security key. The product was received free for review. The video is broken up into four parts, so you can skip around as desired. Okay, pictured here on the right hand of the screen is the video window for the actual ATKey.Pro we're going to use for a demonstration. We're going to do a brief explainer here. This is the website from AuthenTrend. We'll put all these links in the description. There's a couple documents you'll be interested in. One is the user guide. From the user guide, of interest is the fact that this is a U2F and FIDO2 passwordless certified key. Another thing of interest is it has a standalone enrollment feature, which we'll demonstrate. It can store up to 10 fingerprints. All right, jumping over to the quick start guide, there's a key code that uniquely identifies the key. A tri-colored LED that lets you know the process as you're going along through the authentication, fingerprint sensor, and a click button on the side. We have a detailed video demonstration of the capabilities of the key, but I thought it would be good to give an overview of our impressions of this. First thing is no BioLock after three failed attempts. The FIDO2 specification requires that a key manufacturer lock out the key if after three attempts, your fingerprint is not authenticated. There's a big name manufacturer who thinks it's a good idea to go to a website, run through a process in order to get your biometrics back. AuthenTrend has a much more intelligent approach to this. Unplug the key, plug the key back in, and you're ready to authenticate. Now, if you do this five times three, which is 15 failed attempts, it will lock out the key and wipe all the key contents. So that's something to keep in mind. Rugged build, no problem with this. I dropped it a few times, accidentally knocked it across the room once. Things get a little hectic around here. It also comes with a protective silicone jacket that it slips into that you can easily put it on your keyring and keep it with you at all times. Precise BioReader, it had no problems registering my fingerprints for multiple accounts. And the fact that you can plug it into a power pack and immediately register your fingerprints makes the process super simple. Windows setup, no drivers, no software, no configuration, just go to accounts, find security key. Next thing you know, you're registering your fingerprints. I don't think it could get any easier than this. Multicolor visual indicator, every process step along the way, they indicate to you what's going on. The most impressive in the industry that I've seen. And what do we think with all the features and capabilities? This key is easily an A+. Form factor, price performance, build, anything you could think that you want in a biometrics key, AuthenTrend did a stupendous job in designing this key. Now we'll jump over to settings in the Windows operating system and search for account. Once you search for account, what you're looking for is sign-in options. So you see sign-in options here on the screen. And we'll select security key and manage. Now you can see it's reading the key. It's asking us to touch the key, and it was not a fingerprint authentication. It was just a matter of just touching the key. First thing I wanted to demonstrate was the self enrollment procedure, which allows you to add a fingerprint. We're not actually using the Windows operating system. We're just using power from the USB. You could actually plug it into a power pack if you wanted to. Now we're going to demo the self enrollment of the fingerprint. To do that, you press the little button on the side three times quickly. Once you do that, it will blink white. Then take your digit and just touch it to the key. And every time it turns green, remove your finger and just keep doing that until it turns back to blue. It's supposed to be the 13th time that you see green on the key. But don't worry if it turns red or flashes white. Just keep doing this process. And once it turns blue, you'll know that the key was registered with your fingerprint. Now, what we're going to do, just to show you that that key was registered with that fingerprint, is we're going to triple press again, and you can see it's asking for authentication. That blinking green means it wants you to authenticate. So now that we've authenticated, it's back to the self-enrollment process for the second fingerprint. We'll use the index digit this time. It's the same process. Eventually it will go off and turn back to blue. And when it does that, you know that it's registered. There you go. So there's two fingerprints registered. Now what I want to do is use the Windows setup to show you how to add a fingerprint. But before Windows will let you set up a fingerprint, it wants you to add a key pin. So we'll add a key pin here. I recommend at least 8 digits, but we're just using 4 digits for demonstration purposes. You have to touch the key. And there you go. So now we have the pin and we can use Windows to set up a fingerprint. So we'll go through that process now. So we're going to use a different digit for that. Now you can see it visually on the screen as it's making progress. And you'll see the same thing. Once it stops blinking green and it'll go back to blue, you'll know the fingerprint is registered. You also get a visual indication from Windows. So to recap, we've added 3 fingerprints, 2 through the self-enrollment process and 1 through the Windows operating system. Now we're going to put the key into action and use it to authenticate to a Gmail account. So first we'll log in with the standard, this is the email we're using, useauthentrend@gmail.com. We'll click next, enter our password, select next, go over here to the account icon, and select manage your Google account. From there, we'll select security. This is the way you add the key. And what we have to do is we have to turn second step verification on. Right now it's off. So we just click get started. Next, we'll select show more options and select security key. Says, do you have your security key? And yes, we do have the key. So it's going to send you 2 prompts to confirm to make a model of the key. Now it's going to ask us to authenticate. Oh, didn't register. Okay, let's try that again. There we go. So now we'll give it a name here and we're done. You can go through some of these other second factor authentication methods if you choose, if you want to add other things to your account. So for now, we're going to come in here and we're going to sign out. Now we're going to sign back in and I'm going to show you using a different fingerprint. I'll show you using the fingerprint that we created with the Windows operating system. Log in. It's going to ask for the key. So touch your key. So we're going to put the thumbprint. There you go. We're all logged in. The interesting thing about that is one fingerprint was created on the key with self-enrollment and the other fingerprint was created on the Windows operating system, but you can see that they both work with the account. The fingerprint is only used to unlock the device. It's not really the authentication mechanism. The authentication mechanism is inside the key itself. Now what we're going to do is turn off second factor authentication. So the key will have been removed. You can see second factor authentication is off. We'll sign out of the account. We're going to go back into the Windows and reset the key. I want to walk you through all these different processes so you'll be able to use the key effectively. So here we'll reset the key. And you'll get a warning and you'll say proceed. So it will ask you to remove the key and then reinsert the key in order to reset it. Then it's going to say touch the key twice within 10 seconds. Just keep touching it until it works. Now you can see the reset is complete. The PIN and fingerprints have been removed from the key. Now what we're going to do is re-enroll the key. Just want to show you how the key would work if you don't have a PIN or fingerprints registered to the key. So we'll sign in again. We're going to add the key back in. Go into security. Come down to second factor authentication and turn it on. Get started. And show more options, a security key. Click next. So it wants to make a model of the key. Now we're going to touch the key. I'm going to use a finger that we have not previously registered because it's just a basic touch of the key. You're not registering a fingerprint. There is no fingerprint on the key itself. Name the key. And you're asking, why would you do that? You probably wouldn't do it. I just want to show you how the key functions under different scenarios. We'll sign out. Now we're going to sign back in. Click next. Enter the password. Next. Now the key. In fact, I'm going to use my left hand instead of my right hand. You're just touching the key. That's all we're doing. And you can see that was successful. So under that scenario, the key is operating like a standard physical touch key. Test of user presence to touch the key to make sure that someone physically touched the key. There's no biometrics involved in that at all. Not the scenario you would normally use. I just wanted to show you how it would work. As we promised at the end, we wanted to give you some security pointers to get the most out of these keys. The first one I would recommend is only trust devices that are with you physically at all times. By that I mean, always require the key to be used if the device is leaving your physical presence at any time. But a computer that's left in an office or at your house unattended that could be stolen should not be authenticated with the key. Now I wanted to show you on the Google account here, go to the three dots, go to settings. Once you go to settings, click on privacy and security. Under privacy and security, search for cookies. Once you do that, down here you can see cookies and other site data. You want to add under always clear cookies when windows are closed for this Gmail account, you just add accounts.google.com. When you close the browser, that's why it kept re-asking for the key. It clears any stored cookies for the account and will require you to re-authenticate back with the key. If you don't, then the key will be trusted to the device. If someone stole the device, now all they need is a password to get into your account. Not really the best security practice. The next security recommendation that we would make is always have the keys physically with you. Never leave them plugged into the device and never leave them unattended unless you have put them into a physical safe of some sort. Recommend using a quick disconnect keyring like this that you can take the keys on and off very easily by just pushing the little clip. The other thing to keep in mind is that AuthenTrend provides a nice little jacket for the key that it fits into, so you can easily put it on your key ring and take it on and off so it can always be with you. And then finally, recommend a backup key so that if for some reason this key got destroyed or lost, you would have a backup key in a safe location that you could get and then re-authenticate with that key and remove the key that you no longer have access to. That's a wrap of our demonstration of how to set up and use ATKey.Pro to protect your online accounts. Please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. This supports our efforts in helping others with technology. Post any questions or comments below and have a great and wonderful automation day.